Going to discuss sets, relations, and functions. Set is a well-defined collection of objects. Set can be represented in different way. It can be represented in words, represented in roster or tabulation method. Again, using a rule or set builder method, you can represent a set. Number of elements in a finite set is known as a cardinal number. That is very important. Number of elements in a finite set. It is a cardinal number. Two sets A and B are said to be equal if they have exactly same elements. If A is equal to PQR, B is equal to PQR, now A and B both are equal. When we move on to equivalent set, if two sets have same number of elements, that is, cardinality of A is equal to cardinality of B, now sets A and B are said to be equivalent set. Then subset. If every member of set A is a member of set B, then A is a subset of B. Okay, so here it is represented like this. A is a subset of B. A is a subset of B means we make use of this symbol for the representation. So we can say that A is contained in B and A is almost equal to B. A and B are almost equal. Okay. Then proper subset means A is contained in B, but A is not equal to B. A is not equal to B, but all elements of A are in B. Now we can say that A is a proper subset of B. A is a proper subset. So this is denoted by like this. A is a proper subset. So see the difference between subset and a proper subset. Proper subset means A is not equal to B. So here when we are talking about subset, A is contained and it's almost equal to B. So here B is a superset of A. So these are the normally used notations for the representation of subset, superset, and proper subset. Okay. So A, first one is the A is a subset of B. Second one, A is a proper subset of B. That is, here we can see that A is not equal to B. Okay. Then B is a superset. And here the third one, A is not a proper subset of B. So the next very important one is power set. Set of all subsets of A is called power set of A. It is denoted by P of A, power set of A. So this point is very important. A set having n element have 2^n subset. A set having n elements has 2^n subsets. Therefore, cardinality of P of A is equal to 2^n. So this is also very important. That is, when a number of elements of a set are given, cardinality of power set, number of subsets of the given set is given by 2^ the number of elements in that set. Okay. So next one, the operations on set. So the main operations are A union B. A union B means X is a member of A, or X is a member of B, or maybe X is a member of both A and B. That is, the meaning is that X is present at least in one of A or B. The element will be present at least in A or B. Okay, A intersection B. A intersection B means the element is present both in set A and both B. Common element. Okay. X is a member of A and X is a member of B. A minus B. A minus B means X is a member of A, but it's not in B. So this is, we can clearly define like this, set A and set B. So set A and set B, I am denoted like this using Venn diagram. So A minus B means the element in A but not in B. Element in A but not in B. A minus B. Okay, so this much is a shaded portion represents A minus B. Similarly, B minus A implies element which is in B but not in A. Element in B but not in A. Then, symmetric difference of A and B. Symmetric difference means set of all elements which are either in A or in B but not in both. That is, which will be a member of A or is a member of B but should not be a member of A intersection B. So, here in this diagram, Venn diagram, the shaded portion represents symmetric difference of A and B. So, these are the some of the important results regarding A delta difference of A and B. A delta B means A union B minus A intersection B. So, in the previous diagram, we can say that from A union B, if you subtract A intersection B, you will get the symmetric difference. Okay, then A delta B is equal to B delta A. Similarly, A delta B is equal to A minus B union B minus A. In the previous diagram, again, we can say that A minus B means the element in A but not in B. So, this one is the element in A, the element in not in B. So, B minus A means element in B but not in A. So, when we are combined this one, we can say that this is equal to A minus B union B minus A. And next one is the De Morgan's law. So, the very famous law, and you are familiar with this law, A union B complement equal to A complement intersection B complement. A intersection B complement equal to A complement union B complement. Then, we have to see the formulae on cardinality. So, I want to tell you that the most important formula in set theory is this one. Number of A union B, number of elements of A union B, N of A union B equal to N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. Okay, so I think doing problem, this is the most important one, and the only formula we can by heart, this one is required. Okay, so N of A union B equal to N of A, N of B addition, then minus N of A intersection B. Okay, so using this formula, almost all problems can be solved very easily. So, after that, we will move on to the problem related to operations and set. Okay, so first question, let S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10. Number of subsets of S containing only odd number that we have to find out. Okay. So here, what is the total number cardinality of S? Cardinality of S is equal to nothing but it is 10. Okay. So if the question is number of subsets of S, what is the total number of subsets of S? It is 2 raised to cardinality of S. Okay. But here one condition is given, the subsets of S should contain only odd numbers. It should contain only odd numbers. So what is the odd number? What are the total number of odd numbers? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are the odd numbers. So total 5 odd numbers. Okay. So with 5, what is the total number of subsets? Total number of subsets will be 2 raised to 5. Okay, so here one thing you have to keep in mind that when we are dealing with 2 raised to 5 subsets, it will include null set also. Okay, so in the 2 raised to 5, in that number, null set is also included. So we have to subtract this 1, 2 raised to 5 is the total number of subset. From that, the null set has to be deleted. So total 1 will be 2 raised to 5 is 32 minus 1, that is 31. So, 31 is the answer. Then another one, if A given B is equal to AB, B given equal to CD, A intersection B is already given, what is the question is to have to find out set B. Okay, so my request is when this kind of problem comes, make use of Venn diagram. You start with Venn diagram, then it will be easy for you to find out the solution. Okay, So when such a question is asked, immediately draw a Venn diagram. Here matrix A and B I'm drawing. Sorry, set A and B. Okay, so A given B, the element in A but not in B. Element in A but not in B. So what is A given A minus B? It is given that A, B are the element. Then B minus A, the element in B but not in A. Element in B but not in A. That is, it is C and D. Again, it is given that A intersection B, it is already given, it is E and F. So from this Venn diagram, we can easily find out what is set B. Set B is E, F, C, D. So the second choice, B, is the correct answer. Okay, then another pattern of question. It is a previously asked question. In a flight of 50, people speak Hindi, 20 speak English and 10 speak both English and Hindi. The number of people who speak at least one of the two languages, means either English or Hindi or both. So we can immediately say that it is nothing but A union B. A union B. So it's very simple one. We can make use of the formula N of A plus N of B minus N of A minus B. A intersection B is equal to A union B. Okay. So this is a very easy one. So make use of the formula N of A plus N of A plus, this is N of A, this is N of B minus N of A intersection B. The same problem can be solved with Venn diagram. Okay, so this method, Venn diagram method, is also I want to explain. So this can be applicable to all problems related of this pattern. Okay, so Hindi and English. So what is the total number of people speaking Hindi? It is 50. So total is, it is 50. Total 50. Then total number of people speaking English is, it is 20. It is 20. 10 speak both Malayalam as Hindi and English. So it is 10. So very easily you can see that what is H minus E, element in H, not in English. So this much is, this much portion, it is 40. And here we can say that this will be 20. So what is the total number of people who speak at least one of the two languages, either Hindi or English or both? So it will be 40 plus 50 plus 10. That is, it is 60. 60 is the answer. Then another problem, it's a previous year question. So N of A equal to 43, N of B is given, union B thandattunde, then we have to find out what is N of A minus B union B minus A. Okay, so I'm repeatedly saying that when this kind of problem comes, you have to start with Venn diagram. Just draw a Venn diagram of A and B, set A and B we have represented. Then N of A, it is 43, it is given that it is 43. Then it is 53. B is, cardinality of B is 51. What is union B? The total element is 75. So if N of A, N of B, 75, N of union B is given, you can easily find out what is intersection. How do you get? 75 minus 51 minus, 51 plus 43 minus 73. Okay, so that is equal to, intersection will be equal to, from this it will be equal to 19. It will be equal to 90. So this one is 90. Next we have to see what is N of A minus B union B minus A. A minus B means element in A, not in B. Element in A, not in B. B minus A means element in B, but not in A. So it is very clear that it is equal to n of A union B minus intersection B. So what is the answer? Here it is, 75 is the n union A union B minus A intersection B. Number of elements in A intersection B is 19. So this is the answer. 75 minus 99. Then another problem of this kind. It is in a group of 100 persons, 80 people can speak Malayalam and 60 can speak English. Number of people who speak English only. Okay. So as in this previous case, we can start with Venn diagram. It is A and B. A and B. Suppose A means Malayalam and B set represents English. Okay, so total 100 people. So union is given, it is 100. Then 80 people speak Malayalam. 80 people speak Malayalam. 60 people speak English. So what is intersection? 80 plus 60 minus 100. That is, intersection will be 40. So immediately we can write, what is A minus B? It is 40. Total will be 80. Again, what is B minus A? Element in B, not in A. So simply subtract 40 from 60. So it is 20. So we can say, what is the total number of people who speak English only? English only, it will be 20. Answer is 20. So this is the idea. This is the area, or this is the set elements speaking English only. So answer is 20. Then another one, A and B finite sets such that n of A intersection B 25, A minus B 18, n of A union B 70. Then what is n of B? Intersection given, number of elements in A union B is given, n of A minus B is given. Okay, then we have to see what is n of B. Again, start with Venn diagram. How do you write? Set A and B. Then A intersection B directly given. It is already given in the question. It is 25. N of A minus B is given. The element in A, not in B. So it is this much. It is 18. A union B is given. It is A union. It is 70. A union B, it is 70. So what you have to find out? N of B. N of B, we have to find out. So it is easy one. We have to find out total elements in N. So it's very simple. 70. A union is 70. From 70, 70 minus 80. 70 minus 80, so that is 52. That is the answer. Okay, so these are some problems which can be solved using this Venn diagram. Okay. So this kind of problems we can easily solve. Next, I move on to next topic, Cartesian product. The Cartesian product is represented by A cross B. Cartesian product of set A and B. It is A cross B. It is an ordered pair. In this ordered pair, the first element A comes from set A and the second element comes from set B. Okay, so this is one of the most important relation. Number of elements in A cross B equal to N of A into N of B. That is, if set A has M element, set B has N element, product set A cross B has MN element. That is very, very important. Another important result is, suppose you said A and B have n elements in common. A and B have n elements in common. Then A cross B and B cross A has n square elements in common. So this result is also very important. Now we want to relations. Relation is again a set of ordered pair, and it is obtained by virtue of an association between two sets. Some association existing between set A and B. Because of that, a relation is done. So if A and B are two non-empty set, any subset of A cross B is the relation from A to B. Any subset of A cross B is a relation from A to B. So we can write, we can represent relation as A related to B. A related to B. Okay, so using this definition, we can find out number of relations possible from set A to set B. Okay, so any subset of A cross B. So what is the number of elements of A cross B? It is M into N. If A has M element, B has N element, A cross B will have MN elements. So number of subsets of A cross B will be 2 raised to MN, 2 raised to MN. So 2 raised to MN relations are possible from set A having M elements to set B having N elements. Okay, suppose you have to have a relation from A to A itself. Relation from A to A. So what is the total number of elements? Relation from A to A. So in A, N elements, suppose again A will have N element. Okay, so any subset of A cross A will be a relation. So what is the total number of subsets of A? It will be 2 raised to N square. So this is also important. Again, let R be a relation from set A to set B. Now set of first embrace of the ordered pair is domain. Second embrace is known as range, and B is the codomain. Okay. Suppose some of you have some doubt regarding the difference between range and codomain. So I will explain with an example. Suppose A and B are given like this. The set A is equal to A, B and C. And B contains three elements P, Q and R. So I am drawing the relation like this. A related to P, B related to Q, C is also related to Q. So here, domain means first entries of the ordered pair, that is ABC, set A is the domain. What is the range? Second entries. So in the ordered pair, in the relation, the second entries of the ordered pair, second elements are P and Q. Okay. So, range means set containing P and Q. Next, codomain. The second set enter the second set B. That is, P, Q, R forms the codomain. Okay, so I repeat, codomain means the enter set B, P, Q, R. Then, range means P and Q only. Next one is functions. Function is a special type of relation in which no two different ordered pairs have same first component. So actually, a function is a mapping from input to output. It is a mapping from set A to set B. Okay, so when we are developing or when we are writing the function, we have to keep in mind that no two different ordered pairs have the same first component. Same first component should not be repeated. So that the first component should not be repeated. Again, each element of the domain is mapped into a unique element of codomain. Then, suppose we are having two sets A and B, and A is having M element and B is having N element. So number of functions from one set to another, number of functions from set A to set B is given by N raised to M. So N is the number of elements in the second set. So second set element raised to first element, first set element, N raised to M. That much of functions are possible from set A to set B. Okay, so when you are writing the function, you have to notice that the entire A must be used. Entire A must be used. Every element of A have an image on set B. Okay. So here it is a function PQR are the images. So PQR are the images of the function. Then pre-images means the elements in first set, that is A, B, C, D. So it is a function, all the elements of set A, suppose this is set A and this is B, all the elements in set A are used up. Okay, so it is a function. But here in this one, the set A is from set A to set B, some relations are marked, but it is not a function. Because A is not completely used up. Some element, that is C, does not have image in set B. Similarly, B has two elements, the two elements in two images on set B. Okay, so it is not a function. Then we will have different types of function. One-one function. One-one function mean if distinct elements of A have distinct images in B, distinct elements in A, this is A, suppose this is A and this is B, distinct elements of A have distinct element. Okay, so that is the 1-1 function. Number of 1-1 function possible is NPM. Okay, so NPM, number of have A, N is the elements in the second set. N is the elements in the second one and M is the elements in the first. Next one, mini one. Mini function, two or more elements of A have same images. So here we can say B, Q and R have the same image. So from many to one, from many elements to same image. So the mini one function. Another one, onto function. Onto function is known as, also known as surjective function. A function is called onto function if set B is entirely used. This is the important one. If set B is entirely used up. That is, every element of B is a image of at least one element of A. So in this diagram, it is an onto function. Onto function means entire B element. Every element of B has a pre-image. Okay, so it is a onto function. If the function is both on 1-1 and onto, it is known as a bijunction. Okay, so these are the different types of functions: 1-1, many one, then bijunction, that is 1-1 and onto, then onto function. Okay. Then we will move on to some problems on functions. Okay, so first one, domain of the function. We have to see what is the domain of the function f of x. 7, root of 7 minus 3x plus log of x. What is the domain of the function? Okay, so domain of the function means the range of value, that is the range of A, that is domain means x value. Okay, what is the range of this x value? Okay, so domain of f of x means domain of g of x intersection domain of h of x. So what is domain of g of x? G of x is 7 minus 3x. Okay, so 7 minus 3x, should be greater than 0. So in this question, root of 7 minus 3x. Root of 7 minus 3x means root x. 7 minus 3x should be greater than or equal to 0 for calculating the square root. 7 minus 3x should be greater than 0. So that is why 7 minus 3 is greater than or equal to 0, which implies x greater than or equal to 7 by 3. Then in the previous one, log x domain is logarithmic values existing only for the positive value. So x should be greater than 0. X should be greater than 0. Okay, so domain of g of x is 7 minus 3, 7 by 3 greater than or equal to x, domain of second function x of greater. So therefore domain of f of x will be, it is, we can say that it is the intersection of these two domains. So intersection of these two domains means 0 less than x less than or equal to 7 by 3. So here 0 is not included. 0 is not included in this range. Okay, so that is why I make use of this open bracket. 7 by 3 is included in the range, included in this given range. So, square bracket is used. So, this is the closed bracket. This is the closed one. It's the closed bracket, which means that this 7 by 3 is also included. Okay. Then another problem. If f of x equal to root x and g of x equal to 2x minus 3, then what is f of g of x? So here the problem is we have to see the domain of f of g of x, domain of f of g of x. So f of g of x. So when this kind of problem comes, first have a look over the first function f of. What is f of x? What is f of x? F of x is root x. F of x is root x. Okay. Again, f of g of x means x should be replaced by g of x. Should be replaced by g of x. So what is f of g of x? Square root of x is replaced by g of x. It is 2x minus 3. Okay. So, very simple one. How to define the domain? Define for getting square root of 2x minus 3. 2x minus 3 should be greater than 0. Greater than or equal to 0. As we did in the previous problem, it should be greater than or equal to 0. Okay. So, what do you get? 2x minus 3 greater than or equal to 0. X greater than or equal to 3 by 2. So, 3 by 2 is included. So, since 3 by 2 is included, it is, we are using a closed bracket over here. Then another problem, if f of x equal to x plus 1 by x minus 1, then what is f of x? So when this kind of problem comes, you start from the outer function. Outer function f of, what is f of x? This much. f of x mean in x, it should be replaced by f of x. Okay, so the solution is like this, f of x is x plus 1 by x minus 1, where x is replaced by, when x is replaced by this term, we are getting f of x. So on simplifying, you will get the final answer x. Then another important problem is f of x is given, it is x cube, g of x equal to 3 raised to x, then value of a such that g of f of a equal to f of g of a. Just we have to equate a g of f of a and f of g of a. On solving that, you will get value of a. Okay, so how do you start with? So you have to start from LHS. In the LHS, outer function is g of. So g of, what is g of x is equal to 3 raised to x. So in that function, when x is replaced by f of a, when x is replaced by f of a, you will get g of f of a. So g of f of a can be written as 3 raised to x is replaced by f of a. F of a will be, it will be a raised to 3, a cube. Then move on to the right-hand side, RHS side, outer function f. f of x will be x cube. F of x is x cube. In that f of x, if x is replaced by g of a is 3 raised to a. So, in the right-hand side, when x is replaced by 3 raised to a into 3. So, these are equal, which implies that a cube is equal to 3a. So, a get cancelled. So, what do you get? A square is equal to 3, which means a is equal to plus or minus root 3. Again, we can see that. So, we have one option, with plus or minus root 3. Again, 1 more 0. When a equal to 0, obviously, the equation is satisfied. So, answer is E. So, this is a similar problem. Then another tricky problem. If f of x plus 1 by 2x minus 1 is equal to 2x, value of f of 2. Okay. So, f of x is given, that is equal to 2x. So, simply I am substituting 0 first. When we are substituting 0, what do you get? 1 by minus 1. So, it is when x is equal to 0, what do you get? It is f of minus 1. What is our requirement? We have to get f of 2. So, I am simply substituting x is equal to 1. When x is equal to 1, what do you get? F of 1 plus 1 by 1. That is f of 2. F of 1 plus 1 is 2, that is 2. So, f of 2 will be equal to, what happened? When x is equal to 1, we are getting f of 2 with the left side. So, again, I can substitute x is equal to 1. So, it is 2. So, answer is 2. Again, a tricky question. Then, a problem on relation. A relation on set A is given, where Z is a set of integers defined by R, the number of elements in power set of R. Our requirement is to get the power set of R. Power set of a set means 2 raised to number of elements. Number of elements in that set. 2 raised to number of elements in the relation that we have to write. Here we have to write the number of relation. Number of relation in R. Number of relations in R. Okay, so we have to see what is the relation. And this relation is defined on set A. Okay, so in this kind of problem, in this type of problem, when the relation is specifically defined, you have to write down the relation and you have to apply the equation like 2 raised to like that. Okay, so relation R. So the relation R is defined on set A. So, what are the elements of set A? Elements of set A are, it is given mod x less than or equal to mod x less than 3. That is, elements will be minus 2, minus 1, 0 and 1, 2. So, this is the set A. And the relation is defined on A. What is the relation defined on A? It is given that y is equal to mod x when x not equal to 1. So, x is equal to 1 is not required. Okay. So, relations will be minus 2 mod, that is 2 ordered pair. Second one is minus 1, 1, 0, 0. Last one is 2, 2. So, how many elements in this set? In the relation, 4 elements. So, what is the power set of R? It is 2 raised to 4. 2 raised to 4 is the number of elements in the power set. So, 16 is the answer. Then the last question. A function is defined by f of x equal to 5 sin x. What is range of f of x? What is the range of f of x? Okay. So, here... range of sine x will be varying from minus 1 to 1. So, 5 sin s has the range minus 5, 5. Since minus 5 and 5 are included, we can use closed bracket. Okay, so here instead of domain, range is asked. So when the range of f x will be depending on the range of sin x. Here 5 into sin x. Okay, so the range is like this.